What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to the channel and another daily reaction. Today we have NF with 10 feet down. Now, before we get into reaction, I wanted to ask you all a question, just something that I'm curious about. When do you all typically watch the reaction channel? Is it during maybe dinner time or lunchtime, during work, after work? When is it throughout your day that you typically pull up YouTube and watch the reaction channel? I'm just extremely curious, so if you can leave it down in the comments below. But anyways, with all that being said, today we have 10 feet down. Just reading the title of the track, it makes me assume it has something to do with 6 feet down. We always hear, you know, being buried 6 feet under. I can be completely off, but just looking at the title, that's what speaks out to me. But anyways, we're going to get into it. But before we do that, guys, if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe so you can join the tribe. Drop a like, a comment of any other track that you would like for us to get to. Also, we're anticipating NF. I feel like I've said this many times, but I feel like NF's going to drop any day now. And if you're excited for that, make sure to hit subscribe. Also, we have a bunch of links in the description so y'all can further join the community. Discord, this week we are prioritizing Discord requests. So there's going to be a link in the description, also a pinned comment for the Discord. All requests on the Discord will be honored this week. Mandatory. All right, so make sure to go follow the Discord chat. With all that being said, let's get to the reaction. Right off the rip, this sounds like the track is reversed. It might be a sample in reverse. I mean, I could be wrong. Maybe we'll find out a little bit more in the track, but right here, the intro part really sounds like he got a sample and reversed it. But let's continue. It has to be that. Yeah, I know the person in the mirror is not a perfect one. I look at him every day and think he's not enough. My life's a book that I don't really like to open up. I'm 26, but I feel like I live in chapter one. I skim through it, I've been through it, they laugh at us. You think it's funny? Yeah, laugh it up. I always felt like no one listens to me. That's how I grew up. Church is where I found God, but it's also where I learned to jump. Ooh, what a opening verse. So he says, yeah, the person I look in the mirror is not a perfect one. I look at him every day and I think he's not enough. Always undermining himself, always thinking he's never going to be good enough, saying that he's 26, but he feels like he's on chapter one. But I like how he's foreseeing here where he says, I skimmed through the chapters. I've been through it and they laughed at us, right? So that could be something that maybe he's experiencing now as he's reached stardom, or maybe something that he's anticipating. Right. He's like, you think it's funny? Yeah, laugh it up. And then he mentions here at the end, church is where I found God, but it's also where they judge, where I learned to judge. At the end of the day, I feel like that's true. Right. Like, we know God is going to judge us. And so we go to church and we learn about judgment. Yes, we're not supposed to be judging each other, but ultimately we're human and that tends to happen. Anyways, I'm going to rewind it 10 seconds and we're going to kick it back. I skimmed through it, I've been through it, they laugh at us. You think it's funny? Yeah, laugh it up. I always felt like no one listens to me. That's how I grew up. Church is where I found God, but it's also where I learned to judge. Yeah, I had to learn there's a difference between what you want and what you really need. I've always been motivated by comments from people telling me things they think I'll never be, and then I become it. This is my everything. There's so much that goes on in my head that people will never see. You probably be terrified of my memories. Don't lecture me. Let me be, let me see, let me breathe. How they remember me doesn't alter who I am as a person to take my energy. Yeah. Yo, the rap scheme, how he sped it up there with the syllables, check it out. In my head that people will never see. You probably be terrified of my memories. Don't lecture me. Let me be, let me see, let me breathe. How they remember me doesn't alter who I am as a person to take my energy. Yeah. Hard days, cool nights, staring down at an empty cup like I'ma fill, I'ma fill it up. Okay, so we're getting a little bit of optimism in the chorus. So it starts off very pessimistic, actually, where he says, hard day, cold nights, staring down that empty cup, but I'm gonna fill it up, right? So he's kind of giving you this mindset that he has of pessimism, but he's kind of
hopeful that he will be optimistic at the end of the day. At least that's what this chorus is portraying. And then obviously the second part of that, 10 Feet Down, which is the title track, nearly my whole life, but I'll be rising up. So hopefully towards the end of the song or the second half of the song, we get where the optimism abrupts here.
Yeah, my fans made me who I am, but they also deceive me. I've been alive, but live life like I'm already grieving. I'm at a table of lies, but don't eat what they feed me. My hoodie over my face so nobody can see me. I'm on a plane about to fly again, looking out the window, take a moment to admire it. Wondering how high it is, wonder where the time has went. Then I shut the window and go back to feeling like I'm on my mind again. Yeah, seems like we all trying to climb a ladder. It's crazy what we'll do to climb it faster. It's like we throw away the things in life that really matter, just so we can make it to the top and wonder what we even climb after. I know the feeling of feeling like everything that you deal with will never change. That's part of being a human, yeah. Life's what you make of it. Take it, embrace it, and take it and savor it. Ain't about what you did, it's what you became from it.
Ooh, there we go, speeding it up towards the end of that verse there again. You make it, take it, embrace it, take it, and savor it. I love how he's speeding it up there, but let's go back to the meat and potatoes of this verse here, where he's talking about essentially going through, chasing your dreams and your aspirations, but you having to close out relationships in doing so. And then you actually getting there and realizing, damn, was it all worth it? Because I'm kind of feeling empty right now, right? He talks about him feeling empty on the plane and him not wanting to talk to anybody, but he realizes that, well, what did I leave behind? Did I leave behind my family, relationships that I've, you know, passed up on for this feeling, for success? Is this really what I wanted? So, yeah.
Hard days, cool nights, staring down at an empty cup like, I'ma fill it up.
I notice NF is a fan of the high-pitched vocals on choruses. He's had it several times. Like, obviously, this is a good example of one. I wonder why. We didn't hear too much of that in Clouds, which is one of my favorite mixtape projects from NF so far. Obviously, you know, we have a lot more to dig into in his discography. But I wonder if that's something that he was just into in the beginning of his career. I noticed that a lot of underground rappers tended to lean towards that that trend of having high-pitched vocals in their chorus. But anyways, let's go back. I really like how the drums came in on that second half of the chorus. I'm going to rewind it back here.
But I'll be rising, fill it up.
Right here. That kick snare is crazy. Got some horns? That made me think back to, I totally forgot about the intro part of this track where we're going in reverse, and now we're going back in reverse, but it's just the chorus in reverse. It's kind of like we warped into the song and now we're warping out of the song. That's kind of dope. Now, I've said this in other tracks. I'm not a big fan of the high-pitched vocals when it comes to choruses. But, man, the beat, the instrumental here, the production, I feel like, is a lot more experimental than we've heard on the any other NF tracks that I've reacted to so far, and I'm liking it. He added like some horns there. The kick snare is hitting me hard. And I, for some reason, I don't mind the high-pitched vocals in this track as much as I would not like it in other tracks. It's not as bad for some reason. I don't know if it has to do with the instrumental and the beat, but anyways, let's finish it off. We don't have much time. Well, there you guys have it. I don't know if y'all can tell, I'm getting sick again. I know I recently just got sick, but I'm trying my best to hold myself together here. My voice probably sounds a little bit different. I'm really reaching here to try to get everything out because I do not want to miss an upload for y'all. You already know we're on that grind. But let me talk about this track. I really like the concept of pessimism and optimism. You know, he starts off the track talking about how negative he thinks of himself and whatnot, and he kind of continues that throughout the whole track. But I like how the chorus brings some of that optimism out, where he says, "I'm gonna rise up," or "I'm gonna fill up that cup that I see is half empty," right? So I think this is a good conceptual track, something to make you think about. I like the whole concept of warping in and warping out with the whole reverse chorus at the beginning and end. That's pretty dope. I think this is a track that is gonna make you think off of first listen. Again, I will say that I'm not the biggest fan of, you know, the high pitched chorus, and for that reason, it might not serve too much replay value. But I enjoy the track, and I think it's solid. With all that being said, guys, I appreciate y'all so much. If you're new to the channel, make sure you hit subscribe. And with all that being said, I'm sick. I'm trying to gather myself here together. We'll catch you all in the next reaction. Peace.